I think before we start anything, I think we should call sir first, sir. Please, without you, we can't start anything. And Vidya, will you please join us?
That was very good.
Yeah. So this is, you know, we are missing Nawaz here, but we have sir, we have Vidya, we have Sujoy, and we're all in white. Yeah, we're all in white. Yeah, so we decided.
Why don't you tell me about some of your experiences while shooting in Kolkata?
We will start with sir. Sir, what was your experience about shooting in Kolkata?
Vidya is going to talk about it.
Oh, okay. Hi, everyone. Well, TE3N was a very special experience for me, not just because I'm in a special appearance. Oh my God, that's a terrible joke. But, yeah. It's usual. I was back in Kolkata, one of my favoritest places in the world. I keep saying it's second home for me. I was working with Mr. Bachchan again in a completely different avatar from Pa. It's been a few years. And I can't say this enough number of times, and everyone who works with him says this. People who don't work with him or haven't had the chance say this, that he is a constant inspiration. So, you know, my first scene with him, I looked at him and I felt like he was the character. And that really, for me, amazes me time and again. I don't know how you do it. And God bless you with the longest, healthiest life so we continue to get inspired and entertained by you. And I can keep gushing, but I will talk about. Another very strong reason for me to do the film was the script. And when I met Ribhu, I thought he was a very pleasant person to interact with. Unlike Sujoy, who's completely mad. You know, Sujoy and I have a very crazy equation, so we won't go there. But with Ribhu, it was like, I just felt I wanted to work with him. I felt like I liked the way he was seeing the film. I liked the way he wanted to tell the story. So I wanted to be part of it. And jokes apart, you know, I was getting to work with Sujoy Ghosh again. And how could I miss that opportunity, really? In Kolkata. So yeah, I've given you enough reasons why I've done the film, and it is the very fact that I've flown down just for the trailer launch means that it is very special for me, and I hope you all enjoy it, throng the theatres and blah, 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 and blue, blue, blue. Thank you.
Sir.
Oh, okay. Sujoy and me have always been appreciative of each other's works. He's been a little too effusive about his love for me, and I'm always grateful to him. We did Aladdin together, and we had a wonderful time making it. He had some wonderful ideas which he worked with, and then when he was doing Kahani, he wanted me to sing the theme song, Akla Chalore, which I did for him. But even otherwise, even when he was not working, we would meet often at one of our favorite spots, which is Vishal and Shekhar's music room. Talk cinema, talk music, just... and then he came with the idea of wanting to make and produce another film with Ribhu. Ribhu and me had worked together in a TV serial that we did called Yudh. And Ribhu was introduced to me by Anurag Kashyap. And during the making of Yudh, which I felt very good about, because I just was told by Anurag and by Ribhu that, you know, just take your time in doing whatever you want to do. There was never any constriction as to how one should perform or in how much time, space you have to finish your lines. I just liked the idea of being free to do whatever we wanted to do. And with the advent of digital cinema now, we don't have the pressures of, you know, costly film that's celluloid, and therefore you can have the liberty of, you know, doing several retakes and takes and carry on working. So when Sujoy brought the idea of Teen, he had actually come with another idea before, which we were almost set to do. And do we disclose that? Or?
Yeah.
It was a film about Kerala, and we had decided on the story, and we had decided to go ahead. Schedules are made, and then one fine evening they came and said, "We have another idea, and maybe you'd like to hear it." So it took me just a couple of seconds as they went into the narration of Teen that I decided, let's do this and let's not do the other one at the moment. That's how quick the narration and the decision to make this film came. We were to shoot the film in Goa, and because there were some problems about permissions, they were back in my office again saying, we have a problem, we can't shoot in Goa because there are problems about permissions. What do we do? And I said, let's go to Kolkata. And they said, you'll go to Kolkata? I said, yeah, why not? And that's the time Sujoy told me that, sir, this is a wonderful decision because I'm going to show you places in Kolkata which you've never seen before, and how true it was during the making of the film. We virtually settled in Kolkata, and I think in one long schedule we finished the film. It's been always a joy to work with Vidya, and I was so happy that they decided to have her in the cast. But I was equally just delighted to work with Nawaz, whom I've always admired. He's a phenomenal talent, and it's just a pity that he's not here with us today. But truly, we get to learn so much from artists like Vidya and Nawaz, because they are this generation, and I'm in great admiration and in awe of all the artists and the younger generation, because they bring to the table something that we are not used to and we have not seen through the 40 years that we've been in cinema. And that's always such a wonderful learning graph for somebody like me. I watch them very carefully. And when I work with them, I admire the way they approach the project, the scene. And I just have great, great admiration for my two co-artists in this film.
Thank you.
The story of the film was what really was very attractive to me. I felt that it was very unique. I don't know how much of its uniqueness we can talk about today, but I suggest that we should have a look at the trailer first, and then maybe we come back here on stage and have an opportunity to talk to you and perhaps answer some of your questions. But I do want to say that that I want to thank the producers and the people that have put their financial might into it. I want to thank the writers who have very diligently worked out a subject which took me a while to understand. So I'm sure that when we talk about the film after you see the trailer, we will be able to perhaps describe more about it. But for the moment, I feel just let's have a look at the trailer, and then we'll come back here and maybe have another discussion and have an opportunity to answer any questions that you have. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You mean? Show me like it.
কত সময় লেগেছে? ওকে, ইট টুক আস 52 ডেজ, 54 ডেজ, 54 ডেজ টু শুট দিস.
গরমি ছে কি? গরমি ছে ওদের?
Is she speaking Gujarati or Bengali? What is she speaking?
I am trying very hard to speak in Bengali.
No, no, we shot in winter. It wasn't, no garmi varmi chhe, thandi
chhe. No garmi. No garmi. I'm sure you must have also learned the language since you shot there. for 50 days, 50 odd days.
Hey, sir speaks very good Bengali. Sir, Bengali.
Wow, can we have a few lines in Bengali from you, sir?
Sometimes you people forget who I'm married to.
I'm from the same hometown. Can we have a few lines of Bengali from you?
Sir, kichu bole din, sir.
Ektu jani, beshi jani na.
That was good enough. Shujay, would you like to share with us how we are intending to promote the film and what is the innovative idea that we have?
Okay, this is my cue to bring out this piece of paper and read out since I haven't learned it. Okay, so here, listen carefully. We want the audience to promote the film. Hello? No, sincerely, we want the audience to promote the film. I mean, even though Alok laughs at it, but we want the audience to promote the film. So we have tied up with 60,000, how many? 60,000 artists, graphic designers to take the campaign ahead. And it's called Teen It Around. Teen It Around, as in TE3NIT around.com. And you can find all the details on www.teenitaround.com. And the five categories are, you can make a poster, you can choose the song that you want to see, make the game you want to play, choose the information you want to hear, and the final one, any other ideas. Okay, and this is the power of teen, where all the filmmakers and the media and the audience will come together to create a promotional campaign which hopefully will benefit us and involve you in the process. And we would really, really want all of you to come and participate in this. So if you go to www.te3nitaround.com, you'll get all the details there.
Yes. So I know you must...
I just want to elaborate on that. Every producer, when he finishes a film, we all sit down. There's a huge marketing team now that sits down to decide on how we need to promote the film. Marketing and promotion has become a very important element in all film productions these days. And it's a very professional, recognized, very well-educated, academic group of people who come across and give you wonderful ideas, and they are fantastic. I just felt that during that meeting, and which we shared with everyone else, that maybe this is something that we see in almost every kind of promotion in all the other films. So you have, of course, the one-on-one interviews, but you have presence of artists at some of the very prominent TRP shows on television. You make city tours, and you go to malls, and you talk to people, and you expect a crowd to come there. And I just felt that with the kind of budget that we have in this film, with the kind of star cast we have in this film, with all due respects, we are not the biggest stars which can attract a lot of people to come and see our film. So it, no, seriously, it was, I felt that it would be an unnecessary expense to go through this entire procedure and not see the final result. So I suggested that maybe we can save on the budget, save on this expense of marketing, and maybe after seeing the film and maybe after talking today, we could invite the audience of what they see and what they feel a film like this should be promoted and how they feel that a film like this should be promoted, which is why the initiative that the producer and all the people in the marketing department very readily agreed, and I'm very happy that they're all here today, and they will have an opportunity to elaborate on that. But really, this is not something of a joke, it's not something humorous, but seriously, this time we would like the audience to tell us how to promote a film. A film, a trailer of which you have already seen. And some of the elements that Sujoy just read out are very pertinent. And there is a technical backup to that where every suggestion of yours that comes in under various headings will be looked at, will be computerized, will be reacted to, and we will put that out into the public market, again, through your medium, to let the people know that this is what has been coming into us, what they feel about it. And maybe this way we could perhaps continue conversation about the film, talk about the film, and yes, if there are ideas and concepts which we feel and which the marketing team feels is good enough and intelligent enough for the promotion of the film, then we will acknowledge it. We will perhaps give some kind of an award for it, and hopefully that we will encourage people to talk more cinema, talk more about film, rather than do something that everyone is now usually used to. That basically was the idea. So this afternoon we will, of course, initiate something like this, and maybe when you put out your questions to us, we will answer more. But that is really a very comprehensive idea of what we want to do as far as the marketing is concerned.
So I'm sure you all must be curious. Any questions?
Yeah, a little more on the making of the film. I'll talk about myself, and then Vidya and Ribu and Sujoy can talk about it. Suggesting Calcutta has always been a great benefit for me, because many of you may not know, but I had my first job in Kolkata. It was Calcutta then. That was in 1962. I worked for almost 7-8 years in a managing agency house as an executive. I was in the coal department, so a lot of the inputs that came in an earlier film of mine, which was made by SG, called Kala Patthar, a lot of those inputs came from my own experiences in coal mines, and where I had to actually train for 2 months. And Calcutta has always been, at that time, a city that has been very close to me. I've been very attracted to it, primarily because, you know, you get your first job there and you get the freedom, you get the independence, you start living on your own, and you build a kind of relationship. And Calcutta has a very unique way of every evening you would meet the same people at all the prominent places and still never get bored of meeting them, because everyone had something fresh to say, something unique to do, something unique to talk about. It's art and culture is obviously associated with Bengal, but that apart, there's this famous adda that everyone has in Bengal, where everyone gathers together and they talk about various subjects, and it's such a wonderful feeling. So for me to get back there and to visit old sites and old locations, I must have stayed in at least 10 different places there, and as a paying guest, as a rented place. So just being in that environment has always been very exciting. I do want to say it to the production that they were absolutely marvelous in the way they produced the film. Gave me and all the artists working conditions which are so conducive to actually putting your heart and mind into the film. Sujoy was absolutely right when he said that some of the locations that he was going to take me to shoot in, I'd never ever seen before, despite the fact that I'd lived in Calcutta and for 8 years. And there were some ironic situations as well. For example, we were shooting in an old mill once, and almost 2 hours into the shooting, I actually disclosed to them that this was one of the mills which were under the company that I was working with, and we used to come here to train. So there were a lot of ironies like this in the. But also, I want to thank the government of West Bengal for providing us incredible amount of facilities, whether it was in the permissions that we got to shoot in locations which no one had ever shot before, like Writers Building, which is the secretariat of the government, to be able to shoot inside there, to get permission to work there. The kind of security arrangements they made for us was just phenomenal. We had to drive long hours to forests which were near Shanti Niketan, and it was just amazing that despite the heavy traffic that we would face in these 4 hours drive and 4 hours going and coming, that's like 8 hours of just being on the road, was just absolutely so amazing. And we never ever had any problem with crowds at all. Ribu just mentioned that the people of Kolkata are truly educative about cinema, and they know, they understand when they're told to keep quiet because we are shooting sync sound, or they're asked to, you know, move out of the frame. There's never been a problem with them because they understand cinema and the way it is shot, and their cooperation into the people of Calcutta. I'd just like to say a big thank you, and to the administration for providing us this great amount of help and assistance. Yeah, are we okay to go for questions now? You want to say something else?
Absolutely.
Yeah, all right. So,
first of all, let me begin with congratulating you for the National Award.
Oh, thank you so much. It's all right, I can hear you, it's fine.
I would like to know, you played many vigilante characters in your previous films. So, how is this character different from those characters?
Yeah, first of all, we have to establish whether I'm a vigilante in the film or not. I hope that's going to be a part of the mystery. But one of the things that Ribu said to me when he was designing the character was, I don't want you to be who you've already been in so many other films. At this age, it's not much of a challenge because what you see me physically is what you will find in the film. Yes, he never wanted me to be aggressive. He wanted me to have a kind of tone to my voice, which you may have noticed, I'm not sure whether you did, which was almost like a, he's an old man, he's weak. He's an Anglo-Indian, his name is John Biswas. It's an Anglo-Indian family. And one of the reasons why we were shooting in Goa was because we wanted the character to be Anglo-Goan. But when we shifted to Kolkata, we made it Anglo-Indian. There's a very large population of Anglo-Indians in Kolkata, and I had, through my experiences of 8 years, interacted with them. So we had some of their mannerisms and the way they behave already with there. But when we did the research on Anglo-Indian characters there, we found them no different from any one of us. I mean, they spoke Hindi beautifully, and they hardly ever spoke Bengali. So most of this, because we'd already done Piku and I'd already spoken Bengali, a lot of it in there, and played that character, Ribu decided that I must play something which is a departure from that. And that's how we actually came to that that condition of the character. Yes, there will be a vigilante. And I think that if we disclose all that, then we'll disclose the story. But these are some of the things that Ribu wanted me to do. He wanted me to play a very weak, old character who's distressed by the fact that there has been a tragedy in his family and how he's going to go about making amends.
Sir,
Vadir
aur isme kuch similarities hain?
Aisa lagega aapko. Lekin jab ek mystery film banate hain, to kahin na kahin usme ek samanta aapko nazar aati hai. Lekin main kaafi vishwas ke saath keh sakta hoon ki ye alag hogi.
Ji, Bachchan sir.
Alag shabd jo hai, har log jo hai, har jamaa ये इस्तेमाल करते हैं. हमारी फिल्म जो है थोड़ी हटके है, अलग है. लेकिन सही मानों में आपने सही कहा, ये मैं मानता हूँ थोड़ी सी, क्योंकि हर मिस्ट्री फिल्म में हमेशा ऐसा ही होता है कि कुछ ना कुछ एक जो मिस्ट्री होती है वो सामान्य होती
है. जी बच्चन साहब, सबसे पहले तो रूना, आई विल जस्ट स्टैंड फॉर यू.
मेरे बाएं दाएं बताइए किधर हैं आप?
सर, आपके दाएं साथ.
जी जी जी.
आपको बहुत सारी बधाइयाँ.
जी जी.
बहुत अच्छा लगा आपको उस मौके पर देखना और बहुत खुश देखना. बहुत सारी बधाइयाँ.
धन्यवाद.
और बहुत खूबसूरत ट्रेलर, बच्चे की आवाज़ बहुत टची थी.
जी.
आपने वैसे तो बहुत कुछ बोल दिया जो मैं पूछना चाह रही थी, लेकिन आप इस साल जब आप कोलकाता गए और उस समय जब आप 60s में गए थे, उससे उस समय से लेकर इस समय तक की कोलकाता में आपको बहुत बड़ा बदलाव क्या दिखाई दिया?
बहुत से फ्लाईओवर्स बन गए हम और कुछ जी, और बहुत सी पुरानी जो वहाँ बिल्डिंग्स थी जहाँ पर हम लोग जाया करते थे, और जो हमारे लिए एक तरह से एक फेवरेट हॉन्ट होता था, वो अभी नहीं दिखाई दिए. लेकिन कुछ चीज़ें अभी भी हैं. पुचका पानी जो है, जो विक्टोरिया मेमोरियल के सामने मिलता है, वो सबसे स्वादिष्ट पुचका पानी मैं ऐसा समझता हूँ भारतवर्ष में, वो वहीं मिलता है और बहुत सस्ता मिलता था. हमारे ज़माने में दो आने में हमारा पेट भर जाता था. और उस जमाने में हमारे पास जबकि हमारी तनख्वाह 400 रुपए होती थी तो वो दीवाने हमारे लिए बड़ा महत्व रखते थे, तो उससे हमारा डिनर हो जाता था। एक जगह थी निज़ाम जहाँ पर काठी कबाब मिलते थे, बहुत ही खूबसूरत, वो शायद अब बंद हो गया है, है अभी भी है लेकिन किसी और नाम से है। और बहुत से रेस्टोरेंट्स थे जो पार्क स्ट्रीट में, जो कि उस ज़माने में हमको लगता था कि ये अजीब सी एक स्ट्रीट है या गली है जहाँ पर इतने सारे रेस्टोरेंट्स एक के बगल में एक थे। तो हम लोग एक जगह से शुरू करते थे और जब तक रात का अंत होता था जितने भी रेस्टोरेंट्स थे सब जगह घूम लेते थे। वो सारे रेस्टोरेंट्स हैं, कुछ चले गए हैं, कुछ चाइनीज़ रेस्टोरेंट थे, वॉल्डॉफ जैसे है वो अब नहीं रहा, स्काई रूम एक बहुत ही खूबसूरत रेस्टोरेंट था जहाँ खाने को बहुत अच्छा मिलता था। अपने पैसे हम लोग नहीं लगा पाते थे तो उनको पकड़ के ले जाते थे जो हमें खिला सकें वहाँ पर। लेकिन कुछ ऐसी चीज़ें बदली हैं, कुछ सिनेमाघर जो हैं वो बंद हो गए हैं या टूट गए हैं, लाइट हाउस वगैरह जो थे जहाँ हम लोग जाकर के फिल्में देखा करते थे वो सब बंद हो गए हैं। ये थोड़ा सा बदलाव है लेकिन लोग जो हैं वो नहीं बदले, ये बहुत अच्छी बात लगी मुझे। आज भी लोग वैसे ही हैं, उतना ही स्नेह प्यार देने के लिए तैयार है।
मिस्टर बच्चन,
और जिस तरह का स्नेह प्यार वहाँ मिलता है वो मेरा ऐसा अनुमान है देश भर में या विदेश भर में कहीं भी किसी भी कलाकार को नहीं मिलता है।
मिस्टर बच्चन, आपसे मेरा सवाल है, यह वसीम अख्तर फ्रॉम इंडिया न्यूज, आपके दाहिने साइड जहाँ से सवाल पूछा गया
जी, था।
कहते हैं कि वहाँ के एक हेरिटेज है जो हाथ रिक्शा चलता है
जी,
तो आपने इस बार का एक्सपीरियंस लिया वहाँ पे जा करके, अभी भी वहाँ चलता है या बंद हो गया है? दूसरी चीज़, एक ट्राम हुआ करती थी जो शायद ट्राम भी बंद हो चुकी है, तो उस पर कुछ रोशनी
नहीं है? वो रिक्शा भी चलता है और ट्राम भी चलती है। एक हमारा शॉट है आपने देखा होगा ट्राम में, मैं घूमा उस ट्राम में और बड़ा अजीब सा लगता है क्योंकि इसी ट्राम में हम लोग नौकरी ढूंढने निकला करते थे और जब इन्होंने मुझे वापस उसमें डाला तो बहुत सी पुरानी यादें जो हैं वो ताज़ा हो गई। हैंड रिक्शा भी चलता है अभी भी, कम हो गया है थोड़ा, मेरे ख्याल से उसमें थोड़ा सा एक देयर इज अ ह्यूमन एलिमेंट व्हिच अ लॉट ऑफ द ह्यूमन व्हाट इज दैट एसोसिएशन कॉल्ड दैट ह्यूमन राइट्स, आई थिंक दे हैव परहैप्स, आई डोंट नो, आई मे बी रॉन्ग हियर, बट वी डिडंट सी मच ऑफ दोज हैंड रिक्शास, बट जब हम कलकत्ते में काम कर रहे थे तब एक आध बार उसमें घूमे जी।
हाय रिपू, ओवर हियर, Ripu over here, towards your left.
Congratulations to you for the national award. I hope so this film will also do the same. Tiku mein aapne cycle chalai thi.
Ji.
Yahan par scooter. How was the experience of riding
a scooter? Ji. मैंने गाड़ी वाड़ी तो ठीक रहती है लेकिन स्कूटर और मोटरसाइकिल मेरे जीवन में थोड़ा सा कम रहा है, उसको नहीं चला पाया हूँ। लेकिन जब इन्होंने कहा कि ज़्यादातर आपको स्कूटर पे घूमना होगा तो मैंने इनसे कहा कि 1.5-2 महीने पहले एक स्कूटर ला करके मेरे घर रख दो ताकि मैं उस पर प्रैक्टिस कर सकूं। तो थोड़ी बहुत इन्होंने मेरी बात मानी और यहाँ जलसा में एक स्कूटर आ गया था और उस पर जब आप लोग नहीं होते आसपास तब मैं उसको लेकर घूमता था और प्रैक्टिस करता था। ये वेस्पा स्कूटर है और थोड़ा सा पुराने ज़माने का है जो फिल्म में, ये जो आज तक के हैं, हाँ सॉरी बजाज है, तो ये थोड़ा सा भयंकर है क्योंकि मोटरसाइकिल में तो दोनों पांव इस तरफ रख सकते हैं, इधर उधर जाएं तो पांव नीचे रख सकते हैं, स्कूटर में दोनों ऐसे रहते हैं तो ज़रा सा भी बैलेंस जाए तो रोकने में थोड़ा गड़बड़ होता है, मेरा इतना अनुभव नहीं है। लेकिन शुरुआत में जैसे कि शुरू में हम लोग मैदान जो है वहाँ पर गए और अल सुबह जा करके उसे प्रैक्टिस करते थे ताकि जब हम लोग सड़क पे चलें तो हमको कोई दिक्कत ना हो, और किसी तरह हो गया ये काम।
हाय रिबु, ओवर हियर, यू नो द फिल्म हैज अ टेरिफिक स्टार कास्ट, सो हाउ इजी वाज इट टू गेट एवरीवन ऑन बोर्ड?
आर यू टॉकिंग इजी और डिफिकल्ट? व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन?
इजी, हाउ इजी और डिफिकल्ट, व्हाटएवर इट।
सी, आई थिंक एट द एंड ऑफ द डे एवरीथिंग गोज बैक टू द स्क्रिप्ट, यू नो, इफ यू हैव अ गुड स्क्रिप्ट एंड यू हैव एक्टर्स हु सी द विजन यू आर सीइंग, that's one way I look at it. And in this case, I think Vidya mentioned and sir had mentioned that you know, everything falls into place because like sir said that, you know, when we started narrating the story to him in the first few minutes only, he said that, you know, we should go ahead and write the script, and then we wrote the script, we went back to him and he read it, like same way we when we went with Vidya, we you know, we sent her the script, and she read it, she got back, and she, you know, I think at the end of the day, it's the story, the script, which excites you as a director, and the actors, if they have the same vision, what you're seeing, I think it should fall into place.
And Vidya, how was it returning to Kolkata after Kahani? And again, you are shooting for Kahani 2 as well at Kolkata, so.
Yeah, I don't think there's a question of returning to Kolkata because I feel I spend half my days there invariably. But it was wonderful. Like Sir said, the people are so warm and welcoming. My debut film was a Bengali film. So they actually, even before Parinita, so they actually think I'm Bengali. Everyone speaks to me in Bengali and I show off my Bengali wherever I can. I also know songs and rhymes and all of that. So, some slang also. So the unit, I'm very familiar with unit hands, you know. It's just like being with family. So when I'm in Kolkata, I actually don't miss home all that much. I really feel very much at home and I'm back there for Kahani 2 now. And it just feels like I went there for 3 and I stayed on and we're shooting and it's great. And you know, Nawaz and me were meeting in Kolkata after 6 years, after we shot Kahani. In these 6 years post Kahani, we hadn't met at all. We met on the sets of 3. And both of us have, you know, had lots of films in between and it was just nice catching up with him and working with him again because most of my scenes are with Nawaz. And I wish he was here today. But even he says the same thing. He says, I don't miss home when I'm in Kolkata. So I think it's pretty much universal, that feeling.
Amitji aur Vidya, mera aap se sawal hai ki mystery film hai ye, to kaun
si... Who's asking the question? Please stand up.
Me. Yeah. I can't stand, of course. That's all right. Back door. सर आपसे और मैम आपसे सवाल है कि मिस्ट्री फिल्म है ये, कौन सी फिल्मों के आप कायल हैं, मिस्ट्री फिल्मों के जिनको आप देखना पसंद करते हैं या जिनको आपने?
हर मिस्ट्री फिल्म जो है उसमें कहीं ना कहीं कुछ ऐसा होता है जिसको देखने का मन करता है बार बार, वो चाहे अल्फ्रेड हिचकॉक की फिल्में हों या जो फिल्में यहाँ पर बनी हैं हमारे भारतीय फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में. किसी एक का नाम लेना बड़ा मुश्किल होगा, लेकिन सारी फिल्में जो हैं वो अच्छी लगती हैं. एक चीज़ जो कि शायद हमने नहीं कही पहले, वो ये कि इस फिल्म में कहीं भी कोई सेट नहीं बना. जितनी भी जगह आप देखेंगे वो एक्चुअल लोकेशंस हैं और उसका एक अलग एक चाव होता है. मुझे ऐसा लगता था कि ये हम लोग यहाँ कैसे कर पाएंगे, क्योंकि ये तो एक्चुअल सेट है. चाहे वो जो सबसे प्रथम चौराहा है ग्रैंड होटल के सामने, जहाँ से पूरी सेप्राइटस बिल्डिंग को सड़क जाती है, कितना भारी भरकम भीड़ होती है, लेकिन वहाँ पर भी हमने स्कूटर चलाया और भीड़ भाड़ हो जाती है, लेकिन बहुत ही संयम रखा उन्होंने, अनुशासन रखा उन्होंने, और ये बहुत अच्छी बात लगी हमें. दूसरी बात, रिव्यू ने कहा था कि मैं इसमें जैसा एक आम आदमी को कोई एक जगह दिखाई देती है, वैसे ही मैं चाहता हूँ कि वो जगह दिखे. अगर कम रोशनी है तो कम रोशनी से. और तुषार जो कि हमारे डीओपी थे, उनको मैं बहुत बधाई देना चाहता हूँ, क्योंकि कई एक जगह मुझे लगता था कि ये शूटिंग कर भी रहा है कि नहीं यार, क्योंकि कोई बत्ती तो जल नहीं रही है कहीं. और बड़ा अजीब सा लगता है, क्योंकि हम लोग उस ज़माने से गुजरे हैं जहाँ पर बड़े बड़े ब्रूट लाइट्स वगैरह लगती थी, रिफ्लेक्टर लगता था, आँख भी नहीं खुल सकती थी. अब कोई रोशनी नहीं जलती है, बड़ा अजीब सा लगता है. लेकिन ये रिबू का एक विचारधारा थी कि जैसे आम लोगों को दिखता है, मान लीजिए थिएटर में बैठे हैं, अगर हाँ अंधेरा है तो वैसे ही दिखना चाहिए.
विद्या आपकी पसंदीदा फिल्म है, अगर आप मिस्ट्री फिल्मों के बारे में.
सॉरी,
आपकी पसंदीदा मिस्ट्री फिल्म?
आई थिंक साइको एंड वर्टिगो आर माय ऑल टाइम फेवरेट्स. एंड कहानी, मैं कहानी कैसे बोल सकती हूँ, पर हाँ कहानी. और बहुत सी फिल्में हैं, पर आई लव द जॉनर, आई लव द थ्रिलर मिस्ट्री जॉनर. इट कीप्स मी द मोस्ट एक्साइटेड इन अ फिल्म. मैं नहीं तो बहुत कई बार इम्पेशेंट हो जाती हूँ, पर अच्छा थ्रिलर जब देखती हूँ तो बहुत मज़ा आता है.
सो जो ये 3 का क्या मतलब है, हम ट्वीट भी करते हैं तो हमें 3 निकालना पड़ता है, लाइक ई की जगह 3 में जो ये 3 है, TEE की जगह वो 3 आपने ऐसे किया,
तो
एग्जैक्टली क्या, अगर आप उसको थोड़ा एलैबोरेट करना चाहें।
सर इसके लिए आपको तो पिक्चर देखना पड़ेगा सर।
अभी बता दो तो आप पिक्चर क्यों देखोगे?
नो एक्चुअली देयर इज अ रीजन टू इट, वी थॉट अ लॉट अबाउट इट।
फिलहाल हम केवल इतना कह सकते हैं कि तीन कलाकार हैं इसलिए तीन।
अमित जी
रिबू रिबू टुवर्ड योर लेफ्ट।
सॉरी
हाय।
I know to drive, but I've never been a confident driver. But इस फिल्म के लिए हालांकि मेरे उतने driving shots हैं नहीं, but I wanted to do it myself. I didn't want them to rig it or anything. So I actually drove around Kolkata. So it was great fun. Shujoy was my driving instructor, and that's the only real preparation. Baki. I enjoyed playing a cop. It's the first time I played a cop, and driving is the only thing.
Did you get a chance for doing any action or probably shooting some?
You, when you watch the film, you'll know.
Amit ji,
Ribu, the lady over Ribu there. Towards your right. Left.
Can I just?
Amit ji, on.
Over there, probably.
Yeah, yeah.
Amit sir, you have always been a supporter of women empowerment. You know, day before yesterday, when you were at the National Award, an actress sitting alongside you, who is today being admired for her fighting spirit in a great way. Wouldn't you say Kamala now is the perfect example of woman empowerment, given the way she has single-handedly mounted a spirited defense against a powerful man like Hrithik Roshan?
I'm sorry, can we keep the sir, relating to the film, please? I'm sorry. Yeah, the lady over there.
देखिए, किसी के बगल में बैठ करके जो उनका व्यवहार है या उनके साथ जो बीत रही है उसके बारे में जो बगल में बैठा है उसको कैसे ज्ञान हो सकता है? आपके साथ में बैठा हूँ, मुझे कोई भी ज्ञान नहीं है कि आपका अगला प्रश्न क्या होने वाला है।
I'm sorry, please.
अमित जी,
लेकिन लेकिन आपकी बात जो है उसे उसकी मैं सराहना करता हूँ कि महिलाओं को शक्ति मिली, अपने आप अपने पैरों पे खड़े हो सके। हम सब जो है ऐसा हमेशा मानते आए हैं कि महिला जो है उसकी अपनी एक शक्ति होनी चाहिए। 50% जो है देश की आबादी उतनी ही महिलाएं होनी चाहिए और उतनी ही उनको शक्ति मिलनी चाहिए, समाज में उनका एक महत्व होना चाहिए। हमने हमेशा ऐसा माना है और इन्हीं बातों को हम लेकर के आगे बढ़ते हैं।
लेकिन सर हाजी अली में भी अब महिला को आगे नहीं दिया जा रहा।
जी जी जी, ये मेरे पास इतना ज्ञान नहीं है भाई साहब कि मैं बता सकूं।
द लेडी इन ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट, कैन यू आस्क योर क्वेश्चंस?
यू नो I really think it's none of my business to be judging anyone, but I will say this, that I have the greatest admiration for Kangana because she's standing up for herself. I think that is very creditable, because as women, I think we find it very easy to stand up for other people, for our family members, for our children, for our husbands, for our parents, but we rarely stand up for ourselves, and she's standing up for herself. So kudos to her, and more power to her for that.
Amit ji. अमित जी, पहले आपको बहुत बधाई फॉर नेशनल अवार्ड, एंड सेकेंडली ये आपको बता दें कि आप जो निज़ाम के बारे में बोला है वो बहुत जल्दी मुंबई में खार में उनका ब्रांच ओपन होते जा रहा
है। निज़ाम
इज ओपनिंग इन खार।
ओह
या,
एंड बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका, बहुत बहुत। लेकिन दुर्भाग्यवश अब मैंने मांस खाना छोड़ दिया है, तकरीबन 35-40 साल हो गए छोड़े हुए।
सर सिटीज,
लेकिन अभिषेक को भेजूंगा वहाँ।
सर वहाँ का जो सिटीज का जो मोस्ट आइकॉनिक राइटर्स बिल्डिंग है वहाँ पर पहली बार कोई शूट हुआ, इसके पहले कोई बंगाली फिल्म भी वहाँ पर शूट नहीं हुआ, तो राइटर्स बिल्डिंग में शूट करने का एक्सपीरियंस कैसा रहा? और सेकंड सवाल यह है कि कोलकाता इज ऑलवेज कनेक्टेड टू पॉलिटिक्स, फिल्म, रविंद्र संगीत, फुचका एंड फूड एज यू सेड, बट इसमें से कौन सा चीज़ है कोलकाता का जो आप इतने साल मुंबई में रह के भी विच यू कनेक्ट इंस्टेंटली?
रसगुल्ला।
पर वो तो अब खाते नहीं है।
अब छोड़ दिया है, लेकिन अभी भी मिष्टी दोई खाता हूँ, और मिष्टी जो आता रहता है हमारे पास वहाँ से, बहुत से हमारे कुछ मित्र हैं जो भेजते रहते हैं, वो खाता हूँ मैं।
और सर राइटर्स बिल्डिंग के बारे में?
और बंगाल तो हमारे घर के ही अंदर है।
रिभू और सुजय के एक प्रश्न है। রিভু এন্ড সুজয়, আপনার তোমাদের একটা প্রশ্ন আছে যে মিস্টার বচ্চন তো উনি সবসময় বলেন যে কলকাতার উনি বাঙালি, বাংলায় তো হবে, বাংলা তো বোঝেন,
And Vidya also said that Kolkata or second home. Tomra Mr. Bachchan ki ni film korecho, Vidya ki ni korecho, ora onek Bangali director sathe kaj korechen. Ebong Kolkata shonge jato eto strong connect. Shekhane kintu Bangali director proshno thakei je keno Vidya ba Mr. Bachchan ke kono Bangla film e dekha jay na. Jekhane tomra oder ke ni eto kaj korcho Kolkata.
I did actually start working in one, but then that film didn't happen. Bangla chobi. No, no, Anushandhan was a translation. It was a dubbed film. It was a dubbed chilo.
So, jo ek hi film thi kahani aur ye teen dono ki storytelling ka pattern same sa dikh raha hai. Ki udhar bhi hum log matlab wo out nahi kar sakte the ki koi pregnant lady itni khatarnak sabit ho sakti hai aur yahan pe matlab dada ji ki bhumika mein ye bhi itne khatarnak sabit ho sakte hain.
Ye mujhe pata nahi hai. This is news to me, aap jo abhi bol rahe hain. कोई खतरनाक नहीं है फिल्म में, सब नॉर्मल लोग।
भारतीय सिनेमा में कोई ऐसी कहानी है जो सिमिलर नहीं है? एक लड़का होती है, एक लड़की होती है, दोनों में प्यार होता है, एक विलन होता है, वो उनके बीच में आता है, फिर ये हीरो जो है उसको मार देता, अंत में दोनों मिल करके आगे चले जाते हैं। सब कहानी हमारी ऐसी होती है।
अच्छा, और मतलब
तीन घंटे में पोर्टिंग जस्टिस मिल जाता है।
इस फिल्म का जो पोस्टर है जी, तो इस फिल्म का पोस्टर किन्होंने डिजाइन किया है, क्योंकि इसमें इंसेप्शन की पूरी झलक दिख रही है?
मार्चिंग एंस ने किया है और इंसेप्शन का कमेंट्स हमने वी हैव सीन दैट. बट अगर आप और भी फिल्म देखेंगे, फिफ्थ एलिमेंट हो या और भी दो चार है, उनमें भी यू नो यू हैव सिमिलरिटीज ऑफ इमेज विच इज रिवर्स. सो ऐसा नहीं है कि इंसेप्शन ही पहला पिक्चर था जिसमें ऐसा कुछ एज यूज किया हुआ था. आई थिंक फिफ्थ एलिमेंट हैज द सेम थिंग एज वेल.
Yeah, Mr. Bachchan, hi. This is Karmik Verma on your left.
Amit sir, aapke right.
Yeah.
Yeah. My question to you, sir, is that you've been working for almost about 42 years.
43 years. No. 47 years.
Sir. There was a period where, you know, there were scripts which were being written where you were playing, you know, second fiddle to the hero, you know, either the dad or, you know, a character role. But in the last 2 to 3 years, whether it was Wazir, whether it is this film, we've been seeing increasingly, even Piku for that matter, thank you, that scripts are being written with you in the center stage. Are you telling them to do this, or this is happening automatically?
I think they've just become sensible. Sorry, Anjali.
Yeah, exactly. I think whoever did not do that missed out a lot.
If I could write a script, I'd be writing a script for him every day.
No, no. So, are you upset by the fact that I'm getting this? If you're not upset, you know, I'm really grateful and thankful to some of the writers who still consider me to be playing these kind of roles. I'm really very blessed and fortunate that they think about me like this. But yes, it does give me an opportunity to do things that I was never able to do earlier on. Because you played the leading man, and there are certain characteristics, which I was just answering the other gentleman. There's a certain format for the leading man in all our films, and that's what I was doing. But yes, I do consider myself very blessed and very fortunate, and I hope that that there are many others who will come forward. I know Ribu is doing another one with me soon, and it's already
Ribu.
Ready. So,
yeah. Ribu, sir, Ribu. Right. Amit sir,
given an opportunity, I'll write all my scripts with sir. Huh? Sorry,
Amit sir, here, right. Sir,
Kolkata
jaisa anushasan, jo Kolkata ke logon mein anushasan hai, us kisam ka discipline aur kin ilakon mein dekhte hain? क्या हम माने कि यूपी में अगर हम कोई फिल्म शूट करें आपके साथ
सब जगह, तो अगर आप मेरा ऐसा मानना हमेशा रहा है कि अगर आप जनता को एक बार जाके समझा दें, वो समझ जाते हैं. जनता आमतौर पर अनुशासित रहती है, ऐसा कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होता है.
यू नो
कलकत्ते की बात इसलिए की क्योंकि वहाँ के लोग थोड़े से
passionate.
बहुत ही ज़्यादा भावुक हैं, चाहे वो खेल का मैदान हो, चाहे वो सिनेमा हो, चाहे वो थिएटर हो, संगीत हो. अब यहाँ बैठ कर सुनाना शुरू करूँगा आपको अपनी बातें तो पूरी शाम निकल जाएगी. लेकिन जितना मेरा अनुभव हुआ है कोलकाता के साथ, हम लोग रात रात भर बैठे हैं ये बालीगंज में, जहाँ पर हमने पूरी रात बैठ करके शास्त्रीय संगीत सुना है, और एक ही शाम के अंदर मैं आपको बताऊँ, रविशंकर, विलायत हुसैन, अल्लाह राखा, अलाउद्दीन जी, शांता प्रसाद जी, सब जितने म्यूजिशियंस एक ही शाम में, कभी भी संभव ही नहीं हो सकता कि एक ही शाम ये लोग बजाएं, इनको हम लोग सुनने बैठते थे। खेल के मैदान में आपने देखा है किस तरह से ईडन गार्डन भरता है और कितने पैशनेट होते हैं। इसी तरह जब वो अपना स्नेह और प्यार दिखाते हैं किसी कलाकार के प्रति, तो वो मुझे आज भी याद है कि जब मैं महमूद साहब के साथ रहता था, अनवर अली मेरे मित्र थे, तो वो और धर्म जी गए थे, उनकी एक प्रमोद चक्रवर्ती की फिल्म थी, वो उसके रिलीज़ के लिए गए थे वहाँ, और उनको थिएटर का जो ऊपर एक छज्जा होता है वहाँ पर जा कर के खड़ा होना पड़ा क्योंकि इतनी भीड़ हो गई थी। और जैसे ही वो छज्जे पर निकले, इतनी ज़ोर से उनका स्वागत हुआ कि महमूद भाई और धर्म जी के आंसू गिर पड़े। और उनसे कहा गया कि आप कुछ बोलिए, तो उसने कहा कि मैं क्या बोलूँ, हमारे तो ये देख करके दृश्य जो है हमारे लिए इतना भावुक है। इस तरह की वहाँ की जनता है, वो आपको उठा करके ले जाएगी। मैं अपने अनुभव अभी नहीं बता रहा हूँ क्योंकि पूरा ऐसा लगा कि मैं अपनी ही तारीफ़ कर रहा हूँ, लेकिन नहीं, ऐसी बात नहीं है, वो बहुत ही भावुक लोग हैं। हम जैसे कि अभी इस फिल्म में हमने हुगली नदी में शूटिंग की, और मैं एक और फिल्म की शूटिंग करने गया था वहाँ दो अनजाने की, हमारे एक गाना करना था हमें बोटानिकल गार्डन में जो कि हुगली नदी के उस पार है, हुगली में है, तो अगर हम सड़क से जाते तो समय लगता और कहीं ना कहीं लोगों को पता चलता कि हम उधर जा रहे हैं, इसलिए उन लोगों ने कहा कि आप इधर एक स्टीमर जाता है इस पार से, उसमें आप बैठ जाइए, चुपचाप से चले जाएंगे उस तरफ और वहाँ उतर करके गाड़ी में बैठ के वो बोटानिकल गार्डन पहुँच जाएंगे, वहाँ गाना शुरू हो जाएगा। तो अब बहुत सवेरे 6-7 बजे वहाँ एक स्टीमर चुपचाप से लग गया इस तरफ और हम उसमें जा करके बैठे, और जैसे ही वो स्टीमर निकला नदी में जाने के लिए, कुछ 200-300 लोग जो है वो पानी में कूद गए, कूद करके साथ में तैर के गए हमारे साथ उस तरफ। ये बहुत ही ये फैन फॉलोइंग तो है ही, लेकिन एक इनकी जो भावना है ना वो बड़ी अजीब है। और उसी जगह बोटानिकल गार्डन में एक तालाब था बहुत बड़ा, तो हम लोग तालाब के इस तरफ थे ताकि भीड़ जो है उधर रहे, तो भीड़ उधर थी, लेकिन वहाँ से वो लोग हाथ हिलाएं, शोर मचाएं। एक सज्जन जो थे उन्होंने कहा कि प्लीज़ सर, कुछ हमको आना है, ये फोटोग्राफ चाहिए। तो मैंने कहा यार बेचारा बहुत परिश्रम कर रहा है, इसको बुला लेते हैं। तो ये ऑटोग्राफ ऐसे कागज मुंह में पकड़े और पेन ऐसे मुंह में धरे, पानी में तैरता हुआ पूरा तालाब पार करके आया मेरे पास, भीगा एकदम, और मैंने उसको ऑटोग्राफ दिया, उसने मुझे गले लगाया, चीखा चिल्लाया ये, और वैसे ही पानी में कूद गया ऑटोग्राफ लेकर। जितना ऑटोग्राफ लिया था सबमिट किया। तो बहुत सी ऐसी कहानियां हैं कोलकाता की।
मैं आजाद हूं में भी एक कहानी है ना,
हाँ, अरे बाप रे, वो तो बताना नहीं चाहिए। सर वो एक थिएटर में वो फिल्म लगी थी मैं आज़ाद हूँ, और उसमें जहाँ दृश्य जहाँ मैं छत से कूद जाता हूँ, आत्महत्या करता हूँ, तो फैंस जो हैं सर बड़े भावुक होते हैं। तो जैसे ही मैं खड़ा हुआ वो फिल्म में वो दीवार के ऊपर, एक जो फैन था वो बैल्कनी के जो ऐसे कॉर्नर होता है उधर खड़ा हो गया, और जैसे ही मैं कूदा उसने कहा दादा एकला जाबो ना तुम्हें डाम करके कूद गया नीचे। बंगाली में उसने कहा कि आप अकेले नहीं जाएंगे, मैं भी जाऊंगा साथ में आपके। तो इस तरह का पैशन है वहाँ के लोगों में, इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू एक्सप्लेन, यू नो हाउ इट्स जस्ट सो लविंग एंड सो वार्म।
Ribu, to
we only left. Have question for one, yeah, that gentleman in red, please.
Thank you. Congratulations on a very gripping trailer that we just saw. Like someone mentioned, there's a crazy star cast on board. What I want to know is, how are they on set?
How are they on set?
Yeah, because, you know, they come with a lot of experience. So do they probably tell you, oh, this is to be done this way or?
No, not at all. Don't try. Shuja was actually doing the other part of filming, which was production. So, you know, he was looking after all of us. He was very warm that way. Yeah, and food should come on time. So Shuja was,
अमर सिंह ने जया जी पर काफी इल्जाम लगाया, आपका भी नाम लिया।
Can we keep the questions relating to the film, please? I'm really sorry.
आप कुछ एक्शन लेने वाले हैं?
बोलने दीजिए उनको।
जी, आप कुछ एक्शन लेने वाले हैं सर, क्योंकि काफी कुछ उन्होंने बोला दो दिन पहले, आपने सुना होगा जया जी के बारे में, आपके बारे में, कि आपने उनको वॉर्न किया था कि जया जी से दोस्ती ना करें, काफी कुछ उन्होंने कहा, आपने वो सुना होगा, कुछ एक्शन लेने वाले हैं या क्या कहना चाहेंगे सर?
वो हमारे मित्र हैं, उनका ये अधिकार है कि वो हमारे बारे में जो चाहे कह सकते हैं।
सुजॉय और सुजॉय, ओके जस्ट वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस लेडी ओवर हियर, आई एम सॉरी लेडी हियर,
माय नेम आर यू
किसके जीवन में बीच अभिनय को लेकर जी मैं उनसे जब भी मिलता हूँ मैं उनका बहुत बड़ा प्रशंसक हूँ और मैं ऐसा मानता हूँ कि वो बहुत ही अद्भुत कलाकार हैं और कई बार जब भी मैं मिलता हूँ उनसे हाथ जोड़ कर प्रार्थना करता हूँ कि अगली फिल्म क्या आप मेरा नाम रिकमेंड कर सकती हैं कि मैं उनके साथ काम कर सकूँ अभी तक ऐसा हुआ नहीं है यदि आपसे मिले तो आप मेरे तरफ
All right, that was the last question for the afternoon. I'm really sorry. So equally important, apart from the cast and the crew, are the producers of the film. So can we have you on stage, please, as well, for the photo op? Blue Waters Motion Pictures, Gulab Singh Tanwar, Abhijit Ghantak, and Anirudh Tanwar. From Endemol, Deepak Dhar, and Ram Meerchandani. From Cinema, Sameer Rajendra, and Suresh Nair. And from Cross Pictures. Yeah.